Review time, hot!
First things first, the whole election process is bullcrap. And while it is bullcrap, there are still people who believe in this system, millions of people, hundreds of millions of people, and they invest in these candidates, fake candidates who then go on to pass real laws. I'm looking at the people right now latching on to their candidates. I'm looking at the people supporting Donald Trump right now. Oh, and you got to understand how the game go. Donald Trump is a sellout. But not only is he a sellout, what is he doing? Some tricky manipulation here. Acting like he's running for president. Oh no, he's not running for president. He's running for Hillary 2016. And you're saying to me, but they control the whole elections, right? Don't they pick who the president gonna be? Of course they do. But they want you to throw your support behind the person to make it seem more real so that you will support the person when they are in office. So whatever is passed, you will support it. Much like when Obama was elected, we got Obamacare. A lot of people supported that. They can't be too obvious with the deception because people will wake up. And it got too crazy in 07, 08. That's why I woke up. Let's look at Trump in 04. I probably identify more as a Democrat. Oh, that's very telling. But you know what else is very telling? He also supported McCain in 08. He also said Mitt Romney will make a good president. So this guy is for the system. He's for the New World Order system. He doesn't care about this country. You can't say you do if you support McCain or Mitt Romney. And he even said himself, he pays off the candidates. Now, some people are thinking, oh, this guy is an independent type of guy. He really cares. He can't be bought out because he got so much money. Well, evidently this man sold out somewhere. He might not have sold out money-wise, but power-wise, or some selfish reason. But let's look at what's happening with this Trump. So Trump says some things about immigration. Now, what happens is two things. First, you get people getting mad. They're saying, hey, Donald Trump is a racist. Look at what he's saying. Boom. People ticked off. Then you also get the racist voters coming out saying, oh man, this is the guy we need to latch on to. Trump, this is our guy. And yes, you have to understand that there is a racist vote that the Republicans always reach for every election. It's by design, and this is how the system works every single time when I'm talking about the two-party system. The Republican acts like the rich white people who don't care about minorities and they're out of touch. And then the Democrat, oh yeah, they care about all minorities and poor people. So Trump took away the guaranteed racist vote all to himself. And he also did this. He took away the anti-establishment vote as well. Now, mind you, there haven't been any votes. There's just stupid polls. But he's getting the people who would vote anti-establishment. They were supposed to be for this guy right here, Rand Paul, and he would have been dominating the airwaves, changing the whole conversation. But what they had to do was they had to get this guy and divert all the attention away. Now, Rand Paul is a sellout as well, but they don't want this guy talking about the Federal Reserve because then people are going to be like, what the heck, Federal Reserve? What's going on here? And then you would get people waking up. I always wondered how they would shut this guy down, and Trump is the way they did it. Trump knows exactly what he is doing. He is paving the way for Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton cannot beat Rand Paul. The things he says are anti-establishment. And he is the most anti-establishment out of all the candidates running on Democrat and Republican sides. The two major downfalls with Rand is he would run as a 07 Obama saying all the right things, but then when he get in office, he totally for the New World Order. Think I'm lying. Just see his reactions to the fake shootings. He always acts like they are real. Also, the anti-establishment people hearing what he's saying, or the people that will become anti-establishment hearing his campaign, will be siphoned back into believing in the two-party system by becoming Republicans. And that right there is bullcrap, but this is what you get for being a sellout anyways. Back to Trump. Or should I say, back to 96. We see Bill Clinton and Mr. Bob Dole. It's the same old cookie-cutter bullcrap. Bob Dole playing the rich, white, out-of-touch person who don't care about minorities. Bill Clinton, at the time, people were calling him the first black president. Bill Clinton's supposed to care about minorities and poor people. Bush and John Kerry. And you say, oh, you skipped over Al Gore. Al Gore was the vice president for Clinton. It's the same thing. We got Bush, the ultimate rich white person who don't care about minorities. I mean, so many people woke up during Bush, and it was so easy. That 8 years right there was a disastrous 8 years for both ways, for their agenda and against their agenda. But again, Bush, the rich white person who don't care about minorities. Kerry, he's supposed to care about minorities and poor people. Republican, Democrat. Do you see what's happening here? In 08, we get McCain versus Obama. John McCain being the Republican, rich white person who don't care about minorities. Obama being a black person, caring about poor people and minorities. It's the same thing, Democrat versus Republican. And this is one of the more obvious ones right here, 2012 election. Mitt Romney versus Obama. Now, you had Ron Paul running to be a GOP nominee, and he cares about everybody. But no. We got to keep this thing going. The cookie cutter template. This is how we keep people fighting against each other and not really paying attention that both of the parties are paid off. See, when things like race and social class is put in the forefront, then people just get stupid because they act off emotion and they don't really pay attention to what's really happening. They don't really pay attention that both are bought and paid for by Wall Street. Again, here we go. Mitt Romney, rich white person who don't care about minorities and poor people. Obama, care about minorities and the poor people. And let's go back here. What the heck is this Joker doing right here? Why is his tongue out? So then back to Donald Trump. So when you see him saying things that people can take as racist, that's just part of the plan. He's white. He's very rich. And he's perceived to be someone who doesn't care about minorities and poor people. Even though a lot of minorities are supporting him, I also see equally amount of racist people supporting him as well, in person. And a lot of that comes from the anti-establishment vote. People don't really like politicians. They don't like all that politically correct bullcrap. So when they see Donald Trump coming out here talking, saying all these things, they're like, oh, he's just a regular person. That's what people are drawn to. Not actually Donald Trump, because when you look at his track record, it's for the establishment. And the biggest one of all, which if he did become the GOP nominee, he would most likely lose in a landslide, is stuff like this. 11 sexist Donald Trump sayings that will leave women in disbelief that this man is running for president. Who's running for president? Hillary Clinton. 100% into her favor. So let's close it out. What do we get with Trump? Well, he came on the scene to suppress Rand Paul. He was about to change the national conversation. That's what they like to call it. He also would have been the leading anti-establishment vote. And he would have easily surpassed people like Jeb Bush and Chris Christie, who are the 100% establishment vote. People already know that in their minds. I should say brainwashed minds, because people are being brainwashed to support the establishment. He would have stood out because he's saying something different. Remember, this is the same guy who was the front runner before Trump even came in the picture. Also, Trump plays the role of the rich white person who doesn't care about minorities and poor people. And also fits perfectly like a dang glove for Hillary Clinton with the sexist comments that he makes. Ask me about Donald Trump, I'll tell you he's not running for president. He is running for Hillary 2016. Red, silver, J. Ooh. All I gotta say.